kill the backlighting that's on the back of the wall. We can't control that light. Oh, that don't go up in the air. more tunes, and then we'll all together try to talk him into doing one, okay? I'm not gonna say nothing. We'll let him, you know, if he wants to do it, he'll do it. All right, let's rock and roll right now. One for your ears, called Together Forever.
Stop the runners!
What do you say? Were you people waiting outside very long? No? Long time? Well, I'll tell you what, since you were waiting outside so long, what do you say that we just go for it and we have the best time of our lives tonight? Let's do it. Let's make some noise. Let's have a good time. Let's remember the reason why we're here. Only reason why Striper's here tonight. You see, Striper used to play. We used to not care about God at all. We loved God, but we didn't really think about serving Him. You know, we got caught up in our own world. We got caught up in playing down in Hollywood, doing the drugs, doing everything, you know, the sex, drugs, the rock and roll. But you see, that statement, sex, drugs, and rock and roll, I always hated that statement, you know. It shouldn't go with rock and roll, because you see, there's nothing wrong with the music. It's what Satan does to the music, you see? There's nothing wrong with rock and roll. A lot of people think, you know, the beat is satanic, but that's baloney. You know, come on. It's what Satan does to it, and Striper is here. We're here, hopefully we'll be playing the Forum very soon, the tale, the whole Forum about Jesus Christ. We want to tell as many people, and we hope and we pray each day that Striper will have much fruit. They'll bring forth much fruit. Many people will come to know the Lord through their music, through our music. So that's the only reason why we're here. Just want to let you guys know that, okay? Now that I got that out of the way, we are going to take a break right now. We got some popcorn cooking back here. And we got some Cokes. We got a Coke machine. We're going to take about a 10-minute break, okay? You guys mind?
We'll be back.
We'll be back. Hey, people took me for serious. Let some people believe it. Don't believe I was only joking. Rock Regime!
Wait!
These guys didn't know I wasn't ready. No, we had that plan. It's on the list. It says, go into Rock Regime without Ozzy. See, hey, I took him serious. That is planned. Let's do it, boys!
Yeah. real quiet. We want everybody in back of those poles on the count of four to scream. We want to see what you people got back there. You got to show these front people love. Show them what you got. Show them how much you love your Lord. Count of four.
Here we go.
Thank you.
dude. You got 10 more minutes. Go ahead. We're kicking back like you're having some coffee. Thank you.
Yeah. You guys know who to root for. Right up there.
Show we did, many people came in on Jesus Christ. I'm sure there's a lot of people out there who don't know Jesus Christ, but let me tell you something. Don't be ashamed to stand up for him, because we're not ashamed to do it. There's nothing to be ashamed of. It's easy. There's nothing at all to be ashamed of. But I'll tell you something. It's great to know that you're going to live eternally with the King of Kings. Are you just excited over there, boy?
Yeah.
I said, are you excited, boy? Mr. Marco Guido, are you excited over there, boy? Yes, indeed. Let's rock and roll. It's coming up. Now this one here speaks about the rock of our salvation. Rock Man!
Thank you.
good you guys are there.
Yeah!
Yeah!
No, no, no.
Yeah!
Yeah!
That was cool. Okay, let's try this one.
Yeah!
Yeah!
No, 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 no.
Yeah!
All right, that's cool. All right, let's try this one. Okay, how about this one? Let's start another one. Come on, dude, help me out, man.
I can't do this one, man.
Help me out, man. All right, how about this one? Let's see. Okay, this is getting silly.
Here. I got a good one.
What's that?
Jesus!
Jesus! No.
Jesus!
Jesus!
Okay, let's start like this. One other one, then that's it, okay?
Oh, yeah!
Alright.
Oh, yeah.
No, that wasn't it. Okay. Yeah, that's a good one. Oh, speaking of that, you guys want to know what Striper stands for?
Yeah.
The letters, each letter. I think, yeah, I got a shirt on right here. Salvation, through, redemption, yielding, peace, encouragement, and righteousness. By his stripes we are healed. All these stripes on our guitars and on our clothes. What they signify is before Jesus was hung on the cross, you see, he was beat. He was beat with a cat of nine tails. And these stripes represent the beatings that Christ took. We're here to tell the world about what Christ went through. He went through it for you, though. Because he loves you. He loves you so much that he died for you. He came here and he died for you. He was put through hell on earth. He was persecuted, made fun of, and then killed. But you know what? He's not dead. He's alive. He's the Lord of this world. He reigns forever.
Yeah.
That's right. Jesus lives. I like that.
Okay.
I want to tell you all about the upcoming Striper show. We're playing a street scene tomorrow. In LA, you guys try and come out. Also, we're doing a show at Pomona Valley Auditorium. In Pomona Valley, Monday. This Monday, October 1st, with Zebra.
Tell me what you want.
You know, those guys. Okay? And then we're gonna have a special person come out here and tell y'all something. We want y'all, hold on, quiet down for just a second, please. We want you all to stick around. And after this song, after he speaks, we'll come on and do another song, okay? So you guys stick around. I think Bobby can start it off on those drums there. Yeah.
And not only to just hear the words of Stryper, but to listen for a minute about something that's very serious, and it's called sin. You know, Stryper played with a group called Sin. Have you ever heard of a group like that? You know what that means? You know what sin means? I looked it up, and you know, in the Robin Hood days, they used to take a bow and arrow, and they used to try to hit a target, and there was a mark in that target. And what happens when they miss the target, they go, oh, I sinned. It's called missing the mark. Can you imagine having a group called, we're missing the mark? You know, and that's it, missing the mark, sin. You know, I was looking in the scriptures, and there's a guy that was called Naaman. And this guy Naaman was an interesting character in that he had everything going for him. He was second in command to the king of Syria. And I'll tell you something about Naaman. It says he was mighty, he was a mighty man of valor, but, listen, he was a leper. He had leprosy. It is a disease that eats away the flesh. It's a disease like, and it's used in the scriptures as a type of sin. You see, God says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. All have sinned. I don't need to tell any of you that you've fallen short of God's mark for your life. Every single one of you know that you've fallen short. So you don't need to talk about that. But when you look in the Bible at leprosy, it's interesting. It's like sin. Leprosy causes you to be an outcast outside of the camp. Leprosy destroys, and so does sin. Leprosy is a very serious disease. It is incurable, and so is sin. With man, it's incurable. Now, Naaman had a problem, and Naaman finally found a way to get this problem answered and found out there was a man in Israel, and as he was sent to Israel to see this man, the king of Israel was flustered. He didn't know what to do because actually the king of Syria told the king of Israel that you will heal my second in command, and he gave him money to do it. And the king of Israel said, who am I, God, to heal this man? I can't do it. And you know what? I'll tell you, a man today, he cannot take care of this disease. This is something that only God can deal with. He was right when he said that. Now listen, what happened here was Elisha found out that the king was all bummed out because he couldn't heal this man. Elisha said, you send him over to my house, and I'll tell you something. He'll know that there's a prophet in Israel. And so Naaman came over to the house, And you can imagine Naaman with all his 100 chariots and all the guys with all their heavy metal and everything and their swords, and they pull up to Elisha's house, and Elisha doesn't come out, but he sends a servant or a messenger out. God has sent Stryper as a messenger tonight. God has sent me as a messenger tonight to tell you something. Now listen, this is very important. Because when that messenger came out, Naaman looked at that messenger and said, "Who are you? You're not the man of God." He said, "I'm a messenger sent out by the man of God to tell you something. Here's how you're going to be made clean of this leprosy. You go down to the Jordan and you dip 7 times. And Naaman, it says he was angry. He says, "What? I am no way going to go down to that dirty Jordan and dip 7 times. That's ridiculous." And then finally, as he was stomping off, one of the guys said, "Wait a minute. I mean, if he would have asked you to climb a mountain, you would have climbed it. If he would have asked you to jump off a bridge, you probably would have jumped off it. If he would have asked you to, you know, stand on your head in a yoga position and try to look through the third eye, you know, you would have probably tried to do it. But he's just asking you to go dip." And he got mad. Naaman said, "Listen, there's cleaner rivers over in Damascus. Why can't I go over there? Why can't I just dip in those instead of the Jordan? You see, man is saying, hey, why can't I get some, I'll just get some drug therapy. Or I'll just go to some classes and I'll talk to this psych for a minute. Maybe I'll get out of my problem. Or I'll get into TM, Transcendental Meditation. I'll do this, I'll do that." Man's never-ending search to get rid of that disease within. And finally, his friend got through to him. I hope some of your friends who really love you will get the message across because of their changed lives in Christ. That God loves you, they love you, that's why you're here tonight. Because Stryper loves you. Because of Jesus Christ in them. And you know what? They're trying to share with you that all you have to do is dip 7 times and be clean. In other words, the friend said, "Why don't you just go down to the river? It's not a big deal. Just go down there." So Naaman gets down there to that river. He takes off his socks. He takes off his, and he lays down his, some of his heavy metal. And he lays down his sword. And he lays down his helmet. And here he is in his underpants with knocking knees. And all 100 men are laughing at him and looking at him and saying, "There he goes, he's going to go down. Look at Naaman, man, he's going to do it." Naaman touches the water and says, "Man, it's too cold. I don't want to go down in there. This is ridiculous. Come on, go on out there." Naaman got out there in the river and he dipped once. One. I'm getting out of here. This is stupid. This is ridiculous. I'm leaving. And they said, "Please, no. Go again. Dip down. Two. Three. This is stupid. I can't understand this." You know, people are saying to you tonight, if you will receive Jesus Christ into your heart, your life will be changed. And you're saying, "Ah, come on. You mean asking to come into my heart and that's going to change my life?" Yeah! Listen, I can't understand it. 2,000 years ago, this man died for our sins. And if we would receive him into our lives will be changed. There's many that have been touched by Jesus. 4, 5, up, no, 7 times. Come on, go for it. 6, 7. And he comes up and he looks at his skin that was rotting off of, the flesh is rotting off his bones. And he looks at it and it's just like a baby skin. He was healed, totally healed. And he said, "Now I know that there's a living God. Now I'm going to tell everybody that God is real. He's healed me." Listen. Jesus says to you tonight, let's reason together, will you? Let's reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet, though they be red like crimson, they should be as white as snow. That inside disease that you have tonight, that's gnawing at your life, that's killing you, that won't let you go, that bondage of sin, Jesus Christ can break those chains and set you free. But you have to dip. You have to go down. You have to allow his blood to wash and cleanse your life. He died for you. Now, he went down the 7th time and he was cleansed. Now I want to leave you with this. What if Elisha just shined on the prophet and his messenger like you could do tonight? You could shine Stryper on what they're saying. You could shine me on what I'm saying. But wonder if Elisha shined all that on and split. He would have died in his leprosy.
And if you shine on what I'm talking about tonight, you're going to die in your sins. And it's serious, man. And God's the only one that can set you free. But you have to allow him. You have to go. You have to make the first step. Sure, at first you don't know what you're doing or you don't know why, but you know you got to do it because in your heart the Holy Spirit is pulling you and saying, this is right. And you need to do it. So we're going to pray right now. We're going to ask God to move on your heart. There's many of you in here that have never accepted Christ. We're going to ask God to move you and to give you the wherewithal to go and to dip in the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for your Spirit that is here with us tonight, that is drawing hearts to you tonight, that is in the music, that is the Spirit that is wooing us all to your glory. We're looking forward to coming home, Lord. And Lord, we ask that these that don't know you tonight, that you would draw them now. Father, you're the only one that can do it. And Lord, we're trusting in you. Now, let them make that stand and let them be cleansed in the name of Jesus. Amen. And we thank you for it. Amen. All right. Listen. Right now, I want you to get up. And I want you to walk through those doors. They're opening right now. And I know there's many of you. Stripe will be here when you get back to go through those doors. And I'll tell you something. When you get up and you make your stand for Jesus Christ as he hung on the cross for you, when you go through those doors and you ask Jesus to come into your life, your sins will be forgiven. Your life will be changed. Who will be bold enough to go through? Get up and go on down right now. The Lord's moving on your heart. You know you have to do it tonight. This is your night to be cleansed. Your night to be washed in his blood. He will make you a new person. He'll change your life. Make way right in here. There's people that want to come through. Make a way, you guys. Split it up. Christians, you pray. Satan is being put down tonight. Praise the Lord. You pray, Christians. Many are being born again, becoming the sons of God tonight. By making that decision, receiving Christ. There's many more of you. Just get up and come. Get up and come. We're going to wait a few more minutes. God's moving in your hearts. This is your night. You know you have to do this. This is God's way. Jesus said, I am the only way. The only way. There is no other way to get to heaven but through Jesus Christ. There is no other way. He is the Lord of all. And when you take that step and you're serious about it, you're going to go out of here saying, God is living. He's Lord of all. Many more. Make your way. Make your way. God is moving. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Chains are being broken tonight. Lives are being changed. Telling you something. Wait a minute. Listen. It's because of you guys. You guys, you keep up the witness, okay? You keep serving the Lord. You keep drawing people in. You keep being that light for Jesus as he continue to draw many more in. Praise the Lord, huh? It's worth it all to see the soul saved. Anyone else? Please go over there. Please go over. We want to give you a Bible. We want to give you a Bible study. We want to get you hooked up in the book of books. God's word will speak to you. He'll set you free. You shall know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Is that right? Praise the Lord. Anyone else? Keep going for it. Praise the Lord. Keep going! Let the Spirit draw you. You know you gotta do it. There is no other way. Father, we thank you for these souls tonight, Lord Jesus. We know that your Spirit has moved here in a mighty way. And God, I pray for those Christians that are in a backslidden state, that they have allowed sin to come into their life again, that God is a disease, that they need to break away from it, that they need to rededicate their life to you. God, draw many of those that are backslidden and hurting tonight into that room also, that they might recommit their life to you. God, we just pray and thank you in the name of Jesus for what you're doing. Amen. Anyone else? You guys,
There's been a lot of sin in your life. You get in there now too, man. You're taking over again and you're having problems. You get in there and get set free. We want to pray with you and break through with you that the Lord will have a victory in your life. So any of you Christians that are away from the Lord tonight, you get right, man. Get right. And God is going to set you on a solid rock. And God's going to use you in these last days. Anyone else? Come on back. Go on back. All right. Praise the Lord. He's good. I'm telling you, the devil's been put down tonight, huh? God's got the glory. God's got the glory. Give him the praise of the Lord. Father, we just pray again now for Striper, that you'll just continue to bless their ministry, be with them, protect them, put a hedge around them, continue to use them in this mighty way to reach the young and those that are searching and seeking. And Lord, you'll meet their needs. God, go before tonight and bless the remainder of the night. In Jesus' name, and everyone said, amen. Praise the Lord. Here comes Striper.
The good news. You're hearing it right now. Now you gotta go spread it. You gotta go spread it to the world. Not only about what Striper Rock's for, but just Jesus Christ, period. Just we gotta spread it to the world. It's doing it. It's called Come On Rock.
I'm free.
discretion here. Feel free to come talk to us or anybody. Anybody involved with the church here or Strapper, you guys are welcome to talk to us. Alrighty? Sound good? God bless.
What time again are you guys playing?
Okay, well, we're playing is tomorrow, Street Scene.
What time?
8:30 at night. Okay? And then we're playing, huh? In L.A. Hold on a second. Hey, hold on a second. Hey, you crazy guys over there. Those guys are creating a ruckus. Tomorrow, Street Scene in L.A., Los Angeles, on a street called Spring Street. Okay? It's off the 101. Also, we're playing Tuesday in Pomona. Pomona Valley Auditorium with Zebra. Okay? God bless you.
How about it? Were they great, huh? Where's the roar? Okay, they've got albums and cassette stuff on the back, and t-shirts, and in the bookstore. I was blessed by these guys. How about you? Okay, next month, the 27th, Saturday the 27th, here at Mansfield, Aaron Frost will be on the field. Okay? So I hope to see a lot of you guys back out here the 27th. You guys have a good night, and take it easy going out the parking lot. You know, no rain there, but Lord bless you guys. Have a good evening.
Watch the camera. Guys, she's got a guitar solo. A guitar solo.
Tape recorders and record players.